Hello everyone, happy Sunday. We're just leaving church and emergency room twice. Friday night, I went to emergency room around maybe 5 o'clock, got out around 6, went back to the same hospital around 4 p.m., and then got home this morning, Sunday morning, around 1 o'clock. So,
hey you guys, now we're here sitting down at the stomach doctor, just waiting for him to come in. All right, then we'll check in with you guys a little bit later.
Hey everybody, happy Thursday. Welcome back to the video. On Monday, I discussed a little bit about the crazy weekend that I had with not feeling well. And, well, during the weekend, Friday night, I went to the emergency room because I was not feeling well. During the weekend, well, leading up to the weekend, I had a case of the runs. I felt like I had a lot of cold symptoms, like I could feel a cold coming on. And I'm very susceptible to that around anyone, because my immune system is compromised because of the DMD, the disease modifying drug, the medication that I'm on. You're exposed to everything. So I was not feeling my best. My bones were hurting, just everything from A to Z was having me just feel very, very ill. And Friday night, Eva called the ambulance. We went to the hospital because I was saying that I could not breathe. And once I got there, they gave me some medication. I was very nauseated, and they gave me medication that I had never heard of before called Haldol, and it is spelled H-A-L-D-O-L, and it's an antidepressant type of medication, and no, I was not depressed, just to put that out there. As I got it, my body just reacted horribly. I literally felt like I was on drugs, and that medication, you know, is supposed to help calm down a person that's, you know, could, you know, actually be on drugs. And that's not a disgrace to anyone. I've never done drugs a day in my life. But I'm just saying that's the way the medication made me feel. And my doctors noticed that when I came home and they really felt like I was coming out of a horror movie. My body just felt very weird and limbo and just, you know, general all over my legs. Just not feeling well. And I could not sleep for nothing in the world. I tried everything. And I was just sitting up. Kept getting up, laying down, going to the bathroom. I was just on that Saturday. Started to feel a little bit better, but my tongue started to swell. And Eva noticed it. I could feel it coming on. But he noticed it very quickly. And he called it a dysthymic reaction. And he said it's not uncommon to have those type of reactions when you're on the medication. Haldol. It's just that it happens a lot. It's not a dangerous thing, but it's something that goes hand in hand once you receive the medication. So I had never heard of it. I thank God that she was kind of to give me that type of information. She said, I'm 100% sure that that's what it is. And when I was discharged, that's what they said that it was. My body had too much of the medication, Haldol, that they have given me. And that's why I had a bad reaction, just feeling like I was floating on cloud 100. We went back Saturday night, Saturday afternoon, around 4 o'clock. I did not get home until 1 a.m. Sunday morning. And was just not feeling the best at all. Once I did start feeling a little better, it really came back with a vengeance. So I went to get my prescription filled. It's a medication called benzotropine. I don't know how to say it exactly, but I will put it somewhere, you know, on the screen where you'll be able to see it. If you want to Google it and look it up, be my guest. But that has really helped to rid my body of the previous medication. Also, they gave me Salmeterol, which I've had countless times, and I'm so grateful to God that there's no reaction from that, because it helps me out a lot. And it's not just for pain and when you have a relapse. They said it's also used for destroying any other side effects. My mother and I, we went to my GI doctor's appointment. I could not record in there because he doesn't allow that. So I have to be respectful of his feelings. From there, just like I said, I was not feeling the best at all. Just feeling the absolute worst. Worst. And when I was sitting there waiting for my name to be called to go talk to the GI doctor, I started to feel an onset of an MS relapse coming on. And I had to remember, okay, well, the medication's getting out of my system. What am I feeling? Like, am I able to know what I'm feeling? And just as I stepped outside of the office room, because there was no bathrooms in that office area to go out into the hallway. And my mom started to walk up, and she was like, what happened? Were you going to finish already? I'm like, no, they haven't called my name yet. I have to go use the restroom. She could see in my eyes that I was not feeling the best. But I wanted her to sit in the office when they called my name. You know, one thing that I left, and she stepped out for a second. So I didn't want her to come back to me. You know, I was okay. But I say it took about maybe 6 minutes to pass. So I'm grateful and grateful and grateful for that. So that's amazing that I didn't have to go to the emergency room. And then again, if I have to go, I'll go. But grateful, grateful, grateful that it passed on its own. What I realized is from walking, getting out in the shade, the heat in New Orleans is just so heavy and thick. It's like a blanket. Even if you go outside at night, it could be 9, 10 o'clock at night. Just the heat is in the air. So that's my email. The heat is just in the air. And but having MS, anybody having MS knows that MS and heat do not mix. They are not good friends. I do have a cooling vest. They was discussing about a week and a half ago to 2 weeks ago about the possibility of a beta tube. The surgeon, he wants to take his time, and I love that he's very thorough, and he wants to make sure that there's another option that he can do instead of cutting me with very small incisions to have a few tubes. It's not a problem, you see, but I don't see where you're losing drastic amount of weight. Have you lost weight? Yes, but it's not to where it's outrageous. So I understood that. It's just the fact that with everything going on, I am miserable. I'm constantly nauseated. I could take ginger pills. I could suck on a ginger candy. Everything just seemed like it's falling apart before my eyes. And I'm desperately trying with everything inside me to keep the faith and to keep going strong, because it's really starting to get overwhelming. You'll have to go back to the hospital within less than a 24-hour period. Something is really not right. And so my neurologist, he's going to set me up with another GI doctor. I'm disappointed about that because it's like I'm starting all over again from scratch, from the foundation, with the questions, with the tests. I've had 6 endoscopies. I've done enough tests. Just, you know, the gastroparesis, you know, title has been told to me since almost 2.5 years ago. And with the medications, there should be more things out there that's, you know, varies for different patients. And it's just real stressful time for me. Really, always remember that you're a bone, that you're strong, that you're a winner, that you're a warrior, that you're a survivor. You're better coming out of the storm, better than your first one in the storm. Never give up and never surrender. Much love and much peace to you, and I will talk to you guys again very soon. Bye.